Good afternoon to one and all present here. My name is Osama bin Ehsan and my colleague name is
Sharvil Naik.
And we are from River Kaveri. So before we start our presentation, I would like to ask the audience, who is the leading watch manufacturer of India? Anybody? Okay, right. Titan is the leading manufacturer of wristwatch in India. Did it ever came to your mind, like, who was, before Titan, who was the leading manufacturer of wristwatches in India? Yeah, HMT. So our topic for today's induction presentation is case study on the failure of HMT watches India. So this is the video.
God, where is my razor? God, I'm late. Shanta! Shanta! Huh? It still works.
It's empty watches. If you have the inclination,
Just to give you the subtitles, Rashtra ki Samay Prahari means the keepers of the nation, time for the nation. So the motive behind showing the video was just to give you a glimpse of the topic we are going to present. And other than that, the other motive was to make you comfortable because we'll be going a long way back into the time. All the topics we have had for today were relevant from the today's point of view, but this topic has relevance from past. So it was to make you a little bit comfortable. The objective behind choosing this topic is that I and my friend Osama had been personally attached to HMT. My father gifted me an HMT watch while I was in my 8th class. And since it was a period of adolescence, so it became a symbol of independence for me. The watch was not too costly, but it had all the features which are required for students of my age then.
So these are the contents we will be speaking about: inception, vision, mission, and brand identity; growth, the beginning of the end; the decline; SWOT analysis; conclusion; recommendations. So HMT, also known as Hindustan Machine Tools, was incorporated in the year 1951 in Bangalore, Karnataka. It was a public enterprise. HMT Watches was a subsidiary of HMT. Its first manufacturing unit was established in the year 1961 in collaboration with Japanese watch company Citizen in Bangalore. The first batch of hand-wound wrist watches was released by the Honorable Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. It nearly ruled almost the Indian market for nearly 3 decades and sometimes reaching the market share as high as 90%. So the vision was to provide high quality and trend setting watches that combined performance with value pricing. The mission was to introduce a brand range of watches and clocks to satisfy all segments of society.
The brand identity of for HMT watches were derived directly from its vision, and the other facets which influenced the brand identity of HMT watches were values, promises, benefits, and personality. The values part, which influenced the brand identity of HMT watches, included the HMT philosophy, which believed in achieving the market leadership in India through ensuring customer satisfaction, to provide affordable watches to all the Indian people at affordable rates via maintaining technological leadership. As far as culture is considered, since the company had its roots in India, it was an indigenous company, and it was familiar with the Indian culture, in the sense that it was familiar, it was diverse, it was honest and hardworking. The company believed in giving its employees and the people of India a productive and productive work environment, a productive experience, and to be honest with them. The company was very passionate about delivering products which were technologically upgraded and were true to its values. The company always delivered on its promises in the form of giving its customers the products which were available to them in the markets at nominal rates, and the benefits it delivered to its customers were in the form of providing them long-lasting products. As far as brand personality is considered, various attributes which influence the image of HMT was its innovativeness, honesty, and its Indian origin. The other attributes core attributes led to was being strong, honest, innovative, self-confident, inspiring, and recharged. So, since the HMT became a brand which was deep-rooted in the Indian hearts, it was easily approachable, and it became a brand for the people who had a conservative bent of mind, as well as people who were young. Coming to the growth part, by 1970s, HMT had already grown to an iconic watch brand status, and merely owning an HMT watch was a matter of pride for anyone. It became the most sought after gift in any events, farewells, and anniversaries. Enactment of Foreign Regulation Act in 1973 made it possible for HMT to take complete charge of the Indian market, because foreign watchmakers were not allowed to enter the Indian market. HMT made aggressive movements in terms of upgrading its watches. It introduced the first of its kind automatic cords watch in India. But it was only able to meet a fraction of the demand in the Indian market. Other PSUs such as Elvin watches were also present in India, but they could not help the scenario. So as I said, HMT introduced the cost watch in 1981, but it was not well received. The HMT did this in response to the global scenario where the market for Swiss mechanical watches was disrupted, and quartz automatic watches were all over in the international market, but the Indian market was not mature for it, so the product was not well received. The first jolt to HMT came in 1984 Titan Industries watches were incorporated in collaboration with Tamil Nadu Industrial Development Corporation. And the second jolt came in 1986 when 350 of its best employees left the HMT company and went to Titan watches. Based on the inputs from these employees, the company came out with quartz watches for Indian markets.
So, what led to the decline of a company who held almost 90% of the market share? The third jolt that hit HMT watches was the introduction of the economic reform in the year 1991 under the influence of the Prime Minister Nirmala Rao. Narasimha Rao. The major threats were foreign brands posed deadly competition to HMT. The growth of HMT in reform era was again marred by red tapism, hence it could not respond quickly to market changes. Retailers refused to sell its watches due to lower retail profit margin than the competitors. So this is the post-reform,
These are the figures after the reforms that were introduced in 1991. It can be seen that the total production of Indian watches in industry and the share of HMT watches in them, as it can be seen, it is easily discernible that the share has been consistently falling. Now we can compare when the year 2000-2001 arrived, we can see that the company which was